गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ इन थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ लेसन 8 एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ क्लास 8 साइंस. टुडे आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर एंड द फंक्शंस ऑफ द वेरियस सेल ऑर्गेनेलीज विच आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द सेल्स. एंड हियर यू आर सीइंग स्टूडेंट्स, this is the diagram of the structure of the cell and this diagram is of animal cell. So now students, first of all you should understand that this outer double layer membrane which is present in this animal cell is called as cell membrane. So the outermost boundary or membrane, double layered membrane, which is surrounding the cytoplasm which is present inside the animal cell is called as cell membrane. The function of this cell membrane is that it helps in maintaining the shape of the cell, it provides rigidity to the shape of the cell. Second, it provides protection to the various internal contents or the cell organelles which are enclosed in this by this membrane. So it provides the cell membrane. Second important function of the cell membrane is what? That it is providing the protection to the internal content of the cell. Third important function of the cell membrane is that it controls the movement of certain materials in and out of the cell. And because of this function, that it is controlling the entry and exit of the certain substances inside and outside of the cell, it is also called as the selectively permeable membrane or the semi-permeable membrane, because it is allowing only those certain substances or materials which are required by the cell. Only those substances or materials they are allowed to enter inside the cell, and those substances or materials which are not required by the cells, they are not allowed to enter inside the cell. They are filtered out or stopped outside the cell. That's why it is also called as the selectively permeable membrane or semi-permeable membrane. Besides this, this cell membrane, which is a double layered membrane, is also called as the plasma membrane. It is also called as the plasma membranes. Now, I will explain you about the cytoplasm. So, what is cytoplasm? Cytoplasm is a jelly-like material which consists of various chemicals, and these chemicals which are present or which are enclosed by the cell membrane in the animal cell or in the plant cell, these chemicals which are present in the cytoplasm, they help in the processing of various chemical reactions. They are involved in the play important role in the processing of the various chemical reactions which take place inside the cell, in the different cell organelles. Now next to this, I will take, and inside this cytoplasm, the various major cell organelles such as nucleus, you can see here nucleus, then mitochondria, Golgi bodies, lysosomes, endoplasmic reticulum, vacuoles, etc. they are enclosed. They are embedded in this jelly-like fluid material which is called as the cytoplasm. And all these cell organelles which are embedded in the cytoplasm, they perform specific functions inside the cell. Means they are involved in performing different functions inside the cell. Now, the third cell organelle, which is the major cell organelle, you can say, that is the nucleus. So, in the center of the cell, a nucleus is round structure is present, which is called as the nucleus. Here, this is the nucleus, and this nucleus is surrounded by a double layered membrane, and this double layered membrane, which is having small pores in it, means this double layered membrane which is surrounding the oval shaped nucleus which is present in the center of the cell is called as nuclear membrane. So the nucleus, which is a spherical or oval shaped structure, cell organelle which is present inside the cell, it is surrounded or bounded by a double layered porous membrane, and this double layered porous membrane which is surrounding the nucleus of the cell is called as the nuclear membrane. So this is what is called as the nuclear membrane, that is the membrane which is surrounding the nucleus. And in the membrane, in the nuclear membrane, in the walls of the nuclear membrane, small pores are present. Small pores are present in the nuclear membrane, and these small pores which are present in the nuclear membrane which is surrounding the nucleus of the cell, they are called as the nucleopores. So these small openings or pores which are present in the nuclear membrane which is surrounding the nucleus, they are called as the nucleopores. This much is clear to you. And what is the role of this nuclear membrane? The role of this nuclear membrane is that it helps in the movement of various materials from the cytoplasm inside the nucleus of the cell. So this is the role of this nuclear membrane which is surrounding or enclosing the nucleus, which is a oval or which is a spherical or oval shaped cell organelle. Now, beside this, in the nucleus is present a dense fluid like material inside the nucleus. This dense fluid like material which is present inside the nucleus of the cell, that is called as the nucleoplasm. It is called as the nucleoplasm. So this dense is fluid like material which is present inside the nucleus of the cell, that is what is called as the nucleoplasm. Beside this, inside the nucleus, another small round shaped structure is present, and this small round shaped structure which is present inside the nucleus of the cell is called as nucleolus. And these nucleolus, they are visible only when the cells are not dividing. So these nucleolus, which are small round shaped structures present inside the nucleus of the cell, they are visible only when the cell is not undergoing cell division or it is not dividing. I hope you have understood about the structure of the nucleus. Now, beside this, in the nucleus of the cell, coiled thread-like structures are present here in the nucleus of the cell, and these coiled thread-like structures which are present in the nucleus of the cell, they are called as